in conformity with that usage.
And in accordance with the duties of legal travel to the department, brother,
we have assembled here in the class of basins to offer up this memory before the world the last tribute of our affections, thereby demonstrating the sincerity of our private esteem, as well as to the many attachments we have to the principles of our New York order. The Almighty Creator, having been pleased in his infinite wisdom to remove our brother from the cares and troubles of this transitory life, has thereby severed another link in our fraternal chain, by which we are all bound together. So let us satisfy him, be utmost cemented by the power of brotherly love, and that in the short space of time that's allocated to us here, that we can wisely and usefully employ our time, and in the reciprocal intercourse of some kind and friendly acts, willfully promote the welfare and happiness of each other. All merciful Father, into thy hands we commend the spirit of our beloved brother. The will of God is accomplished. Amen.
So it be.
Brother, once again we've been called to perform solemn duties of the dead. The mournful note that betokened the departure from this earthly tabernacle has again alarmed the outer door, and the letterhead has been taken to smuggle the numbers into the unknown land where our fathers have gone before. Our brother has reached the end of life. That brittle thread which bound him to earth has been severed and delivered his wingless flesh back into the unknown land. Silver cord is not loosened. Golden bowl is broken. Picture is broken at the fountain, but we'll loose at the system. Thus shall return to the earth as it was, in the spirit of the God that gave it. Brethren, we know that life is so uncertain, that all of our earthly pursuits are in vain. But let us no longer postpone that all-important concern for planning for eternity. Let us embrace the present moment while time and opportunity are offered, to provide against that great change when all the pomps and pleasures of this fleeting world shall fall upon us. And the recollections of a virtue and a well-spent life yield to us the only comfort and consolation. We shall not be unprepared and hurried into the presence of that all-wise and merciful judge to whom all the secrets of our hearts are known. But in that great day of reckoning, we too shall be ready to stand and give a good account of our stewardship while here on earth. The lambskin neighbor, his numerable venison and a particular badge of a mason. It's more ancient than the gold or fleece of Roman eagle. He was properly worn more honorable than a star and garter or any other order that can be conferred on any man by king, prince, or potentate. He would have to be a man. This I deposit on the task of our beloved brother. By this act, we're reminded of the universal dominion of death and how the arms of friendship cannot interpose the king of terror. Now, the seal of fraternal love cannot protect his victims, nor can the charms of innocence and youth avert his fatal test, because all must die. But how comforting it is to know that our Redeemer liveth, and he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. This evergreen, which once marked a temporary resting place of one illustrious and masonic history, is an emblem of our enduring faith in immortality of the soul. By it, we are reminded of that imperishable part of man that survives the grave and bears the nearest affinity to the supreme intelligence which pervades all of nature and can never die. And finally, though like our brother, we too shall be called to the holiness of death. But through the love and goodness of our supreme grandmaster, we may confidently hope that like this evergreen, our souls shall flourish thereafter in eternal stream. And the arms are crossed upon the breast. He cherishes memory there. The arms extended above the head. Extend this soul to God to gain. The arms are lost to the side, the counter side is about to get the earth. It's earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. All right, for the brothers to assist me now in the grand public, the Sonic Dynamics. The duty we owe to the dead is done. What remains is that we who are living should so live. And by our actions, we become coming up the day of faith that we may neither be surprised or leave our sins uncancelled or God unappeased. And that in our turn, when our body is sent to the earth, it is the hope that our spirit will send to a vision of eternal life. Whatever fate may befall us in this life, may the mother of our life be for the past, cherish it. For the present, for the future, faith. Now then, on behalf of the most worshipful sons of life, the Bay of Name jurisdiction of California, which is the Honorable Omar, escape is the Grandmaster.
let us tend to you the government and things at the deep sea. And we pray that he who tempers the wind to the shore level will give you comfort, consolation, that you be brought to realize that our brother's spirit is happy in his father's home, that home where God wipes away all tears from you.